Welcome, one and everyone, to this week's episode of Scotch and Smoke Rings. I am your neighborhood friendly Oxhorn, here with you today with my suspender set to maximum stun. So glad you're here with me on this show where we cover all ranges of topics, including Scotch, that fine gentlemanly beverage, smoke rings produced by cigars and or tobacco pipes, video game lore and trivia, or any other gentlemanly pursuits that happen to be on your or my mind. We've got a fantastic show for you today. As you probably noticed, things look a little different. And that is because I have launched a brand new website, scotchandsmokerings.com. Patrica is reminding me, of course, that the not live ticker is still showing. All right. It should be hidden now, okay? There you go. The not live ticker is now gone. Everything's live. Anyway, scotchandsmokerings.com. Brand new website. I decided to take my show, which has normally been at oxhorn.com, and just sort of migrated over here to scotchandsmokerings.com. Of course, if you're at oxhorn.com/live show right now, then you are still watching the show. That's because I didn't actually remove it. It's just showing it at two places. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the link for you, paste it into the chat, and then pause for 15 seconds so that you can go to scotchandsmokerings.com right now if you want. And you're at oxhorn.com. All right, here's the link. All right, and I'm going to not do anything interesting for 15 seconds so that you don't miss anything. Go. So now you guys are at scotchandsmokerings.com, and you didn't miss anything because I didn't do anything whatsoever. I just sat there not being interesting at all. Anyway, so now you're here. Do me a favor. Click the Google Plus button. Click the like button. Click the tweet button so that we can get this thing up on Google ASH, the proverbial P. Thank you all very much. But other than that, I hope you guys like the new website, scotchandsmokerings.com. You're going to be able to find a landing page for all of my videos. Click episodes and you'll be able to go through all of the old episodes. I'm still uploading some of the really, really old ones, but a lot of the newer old ones are there right now. You know, I just think this is going to be a better experience for everyone. So, anyway, we got to get to the scotch and the smoke rings. What? We're 2 minutes into it and I haven't actually set anything on fire. That is not classy here at oxhorn.com. So, I have packed my pipe. This is a meerschaum pipe. It's made from a material called meerschaum, which is German for sea foam, because it's actually buoyant. It was discovered kind of floating on the water. It's made from compressed seashells and fishbone over millions and millions of years. It's really porous. It absorbs the tar and the nicotine from the tobacco, and it turns a sort of ebony color over time as you smoke it. Anyway, it's a great substance to smoke tobacco with, so that's why they make it into pipes. Anyway, this is my meerschaum pipe. I just got it a few weeks ago from an antique shop here in Seattle, and I've smoked it a few times, and I gotta say, it's one of my best smoking pipes. So, here we go. Very nice. Gab17 is in the chat right now saying, gross, tobacco, bleh, gross. Yeah, okay, I understand there are people out there who are not terribly excited at the idea of tobacco. And that's totally fine, whatever. You have your own personal likes and dislikes. But what I have done is I have written an about page here at the new scotchandsmokerings.com, which I think you should read. It's pretty interesting, if I do say so myself. The author must just be full of so much creativity and personality that it oozes out of every word that he writes on the page. Whoever that author might be. Yeah. Anyway, so after the show, click the About link at the very top and read it. It's interesting. It'll explain to you my personal philosophy on Scotch, tobacco products, cigars, and/or pipes. So, anyway, There we go. I'm now lit up. I'm going to tamp it down a little bit, crush the ash on the top here. Just so I can get a nice, even burn. And of course, what kind of show about scotch and smoke rings would be complete without scotch? This is my scotch glass. This is my scotch bottle. Today, we are drinking Canapague Castle. I don't know if I pronounced that right. I am Irish, but I'm not Gaelic. Canapague. Anyway, it looks good. Aged 12 years, single malt Irish whiskey. Irish whiskey? What? Wait a minute. If it's Irish whiskey, it can't be scotch. This was in the scotch section. Why am I drinking this? Why was this in the scotch section? Alright, well, I guess tonight I'm going to have to lie to you all. Tonight, this is not scotch and smoke rings. Tonight, this is Irish and smoke rings. It's fitting, I am Irish, but I don't know. There's not the alliteration, scotch and smoke rings, Irish and smoke rings, I don't know. Anyway, I just discovered this, and as you can see, I've had a few drinks. But it's not scotch, it's Irish. Irish whiskey. 12 years, though. It's going to be good. And look, cork. I do love myself a good cork. Fantastic. There we go. Great show for you tonight, ladies and gents. You guys have been submitting fan art like crazy. I've got all sorts of stuff from you that I'm going to show off. So look forward to that, which I will do momentarily. I've been doing a lot of reading recently. I'm going to share with you some of what I read. And then, of course, after you're fully and completely bored with my personal musings, I'll take your questions, and we will have a grand old time. It's just the nature of the beast that you have to relight your pipe a number of times throughout its gentlemanly smoking. But that's the way it goes. Cheers. All right, ladies and gents, time to show off the fan art that you've sent to me. Let me see if I can get this going. All right. This was submitted by Greg Hartung. There you go. Now you can see it. And it's a little bit of a comic. Oh, my screen is freaking out over here. All right. So we have a panda over here in the corner saying, "Oh, greetings, fellow Taran. I am a monk from the remote realm of Pandaria. It is rumored my people shall aid you and your allies in the times of need soon." He spelled rumored with an E. I don't know. It's okay. "I shall relish the chance to be a part of your face." And then Oxhorn says, "Yeah, no offense, but seeing that you are both somewhat cute and furry, your kind will no doubt ruin the Horde's image of consisting of hardcore races. You will get no respect from me." Nicely done, Greg Hartung. You know my stance on the pandas to a T. So thank you for that, Greg. Nicely done. This is a picture by Patrica. So this was me and my brother at BlizzCon a few weeks ago. She decided to take this picture and do some creative editing to it. So, Oxhorn, obviously me, there I am. She needed to point me out for some reason. So that's me, apparently. This, of course, my brother, Brian Dennis, a.k.a. Oxhorn's brother, Irula. And it says, "Hello, my name is Brian Dennis. Don't worry, Bean, the fangirls still love you." Me? Nah, that was funny. XD, not so much. Love from Patrica. Okay, so hating on my brother while he's not even here to defend himself. Oh, Patrica, that is a low blow, I've got to say. Ouch. All right, moving on to the next one. This was submitted by Daniel Rosencrantz. And it says Oxhorn Epicness with a lens flare. No, I take that back. Two lens flares, one there and one there. That's double the epicness. Okay, so thank you for that one, Daniel Rosencrantz. And then there's this from BlizzCon. I was at a Cursed Gaming party. As you can see, I spilled some scotch on my shirt there, apparently. And an awesome fan found me and decided to take a picture. So there we go. And I've got some sunglasses on my hat for some reason. I guess my hat had too much to drink. I don't know. So thank you for submitting that one, Kendra. And then there's this one. So this is the very first fan that found me at BlizzCon. I remember taking this picture. I hadn't even changed out of my traveling shirt. I was still in my airport clothing. No Oxhorn shirt on me, and this fan saw me in line to check into my hotel, pulled me aside, and said, "Oxhorn, we have to take a picture." This is Linda Laude, and she was very nice and very sweet. So it was great seeing her at BlizzCon earlier this year. And that's it. That is all the fan art for now. Oh, but I have some fan poetry. That's right, fan poetry. You guys are you wax poetic on a number of occasions. Time for me to get my poetic... time for me to get into a poetic stance, I guess, so that I can give proper justice to this lovely poem written by one of my many fans. It's time to build up some nicotine courage here. Get on with it, Gabby17. I'm afraid you're at the wrong show. This is called Scotch and Smoke Rings, not talking about sparkly vampires because Gabby likes them. No, wrong show, I'm sorry. This is a manly show. This is a classy show. And I will take a break to blow my smoke rings whenever I darn well want to. So, there you go. Just letting you know. All right, moving on. We have this awesome poem by Cloud... Wait, who is it by? No, it's by Chris Horton. The fantastic Chris Horton. He says in this lovely poem, I'll read it to you with some poetic verbiage. He says, "I just saw at Oxhorn.com that you're getting married. I wish you both a long and joyous wedding." This is, of course, true. He read correctly. And here is his poem. Wet the pipes. Here we go. "Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be sheltered to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other." Oh, this is touching me. "Now there is no more loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two bodies, but there is one life before you. Aww. Go now to your dwelling place to enter into the days of your togetherness. And may your days be good and long upon the earth." Okay, I have to admit, that's pretty, pretty sweet. Oh, that's pretty adorable. I'm sure that Nova, the lovely Nova, is going to really appreciate reading that, because I did as well. I did as well. So thank you for that very much, Chris Horton. That was beautifully done. Now, we have a few more segments before we get to your questions. How do you, gentlemen? We're all about education here at scotchandsmokerings.com. We teach people how to be gentlemen, because there is a distinct lack of gentlemanly behavior in the world. I try to curb that with this program. If friends stand up to greet a gentleman when he stops by their table, a gentleman urges them immediately to return to their seats. Don't let them linger. You're not that important. Okay, this is a good one. Very pertinent. It's called Hold the Sauce. Any gentleman may have friends who do not drink alcohol. Gabby. Whatever the reason for that choice, religious belief, an addiction, or other health concerns, a gentleman respects it. He does not pressure anyone to drink, neither does he ask probing questions. When he is serving as a host in his own home or in a restaurant, he makes certain that his non-drinking friends have plenty of appealing non-alcoholic options. If a gentleman chooses not to drink alcohol, he does not impose that decision on other people. That's a good one to remember. If he is offered a cocktail, he may say, thanks, genuinely, but I don't drink alcohol. I'd like a soda or some sparkling water. Whatever you have handy. He offers no further explanation. Timeless advice from How to Be a Gentleman. One more before we move on. The gift of giving. A gentleman knows that it is a very dangerous thing to ask another person, what do you want for Christmas? At best, the answer will be, I don't know, surprise me. At worst, it will be something a gentleman cannot provide. In either case, the answer will probably not be what the gentleman wants to hear. When he is planning to buy a gift for a friend or a loved one, his best option will be to watch carefully and listen closely, in hopes of picking up helpful hints. This is pertinent because Christmas is just around the corner. Whenever he plans to buy a gift, he goes shopping well ahead of time. He always does his best to avoid a last-minute panic, which almost inevitably leads to acts of desperation and gift-giving disasters. Ah, so true. So true. Love this wisdom. Thank you. Next up is This Day in History, and this one isn't even made by me. This was submitted by Cloud Can Talk, a friend of Patrick's. This Day in History, November 10th, 1951, is the first long-distance telephone call without operator assistance. Pretty fascinating. The first telephone call without operator assistance. Long distance. Pretty cool, I gotta say. All right, that's it. It's now up to you. Ladies and gentlemen, what is on your mind? I am here to answer your questions because I, of course, have the answers. Why wouldn't I? Let's get set up here. So feel free to ask me a question on here, this chat. I, of course, am paying rapt attention. And I forgot to tweet this. Okay, tweeting now. All right, there, now people can come. I'm also on Twitter. Ah, my computer's spazzing. Anyway, I'm at Twitter, @Oxhorn. That's @Oxhorn. I give preference to Twitter because it's easier for me, just the way it goes. I am also on Facebook, facebook.com/Oxhorn page. Let me give you a link if you would like to give me a question on Facebook. There is the link. Feel free to go there and ask me a question. I will do my best to answer it. In fact, just post your question on the link I just spammed out that says streaming live right now. Just post it as a reply to that, and I will be sure to give it due diligence. Cheers, ladies and gents. Ah. It's what happens when you talk too much. Your light goes out. It's a problem. I wish I could have someone here to just talk for me so that I could spend my valuable time smoking my pipe. Does anyone want to volunteer for that? Read my mind and speak my words so that I can practice my smoke rings? Gonzalo the Goblin on Twitter says, what are your thoughts about having WoW Gold buying websites encroaching on your website? They don't, to my knowledge. Sometimes it happens, but when it does, I always ban them. So I can't control what ads Google decides to put on my website, but when I find some that are naughty, like gold-selling websites, I always take them and ban them. So if you find a gold-selling website, link it to me, and I'll make sure that they never appear here at ScotchandSmokeRings.com. You have to get used to saying that. Blind Seth on Twitter says, hey Ox, greetings from Norway. What are your thoughts on Skyrim? I'm pretty impressed about Skyrim. By the way, thank you for your Norwegian well wishes. I do love Norway. I'm pretty excited. I'm looking forward to it. I can't give you a full a review because I haven't really done anything besides see the trailer, but the trailer looks great and I'm excited. Erica on Facebook says, where is the lovely Miss Nova? She's feeling a little under the weather. She's curled up in bed, staying warm right now, but she'll be feeling better later, and when she is feeling better, I will make a point of having her come on camera. Deathica says, Oxhorn, your show is a lifesaver tonight. I'm working overtime till 9, and I bet your boss would be really happy that you're watching this instead of working. Or maybe you're multitasking. That's great. If you're multitasking, keep on going. After all, people listen to music and work at the same time, right? Why, therefore, can't they watch a gentlemanly guy do a gentlemanly broadcast and work at the same time? I think you're doing it right. Go for it. Keep on trucking. I am here for you until 8 when I turn off the camera and go eat dinner and have a good evening. Sen Sukaro says, Oxhorn, how dost thou gain so much knowledge? I dost gain so much knowledge partly from worldly experience and the wisdom of the ancients whom I have studied, and partly due to my said bonus, the powers of which I have explained on numerous occasions in the past. You know, these things combined brings forth the power and majesty of Oxhorn. Something I can't control. I wish I could be humble about these things, but I would be lying. What? Mike Chessel on Twitter says, I noticed your suspenders are poppy-less. Is the poppy only a tradition in Canada? And then he included some fantastic hashtags like Oxhorn, Pone, Hacks, Sauce, 11-11-11. Oh, the date, well, that's tomorrow. Well, I mean, maybe the date for you today, but anyway. And then Smoke Ring. Poppy, like the flower, like having a little poppy embedded in the suspender. I've seen that in television shows, like people who wear a nice jacket or a vest, and they put a little poppy here, but I've never seen it on suspenders. That may be a Canadian thing, I'm not sure. Who knows, maybe I'll have to start getting a collection of poppies to bring to the studio. We'll see. Gort is in the chat. All right, good to have you, Gort. And he says on Twitter, who is your favorite superhero? I'm just reading the repetition of vowels, which is fantastic. Who is my favorite superhero? Gambit. Do any of you know Gambit? From, like, X-Men? He was the Louisiana guy with like, the stick and the cards, like the playing cards. He can make him turn into, like, lightning or fire or something, and he throws the playing cards. That guy was so cool. Plus, he had Rogue, and Rogue was pretty fantastic. If, of course, the cartoon from the 80s or 90s that I watched is actually within the canon of superhero lore. Yeah. Anyway, so that brings me back to my childhood, watching Saturday morning cartoons. Oh, that's great. Anyway, great question. Thank you for that, Gort. Gambit. I really enjoyed Gambit. He was a great, great superhero. Awesome accent, by the way. Old Ironbark says, Ox, are you planning to play Skyrim? There's apparently a lot of, apparently my fans are all of Flutter, or all of Twitter about this video game, Skyrim. I guess I'll have to play it. You know, I've seen a few previews. Has the game been released? Elder Scrolls? Fatwa? Says Thoradan. Skyrim, says the Dan Man. Am I pronouncing it wrong? Yeah. All right. Oh, Midnight Tonight. Oh, it gets released tomorrow on 11-11-11. All right. Remember, the 11th of November. It doesn't really work. Does it? Anyway, yeah, it sounds good. I'll have to check it out. After work, maybe I'll go and pick it up and then give you guys a review. Gort, my man, I want to know about your pipe experience. So, for those who don't know, Gort is picking out some pipes. He's going to become a pipe guy. And I want to know all about his pipe collection. How many do you have now, Gort? Do you have any pics of your pipe collection that you're willing to share with the viewing several? Gorn says it's hard to keep it lit. I have one little corn cob. Okay. That's right. That's my corn cob. I got this in a Seattle antique shop a few weeks ago. It's, oh my gosh, it's the biggest corn cob. It's like the entire cob made into a pipe. Brian smoked this on the show. Gordon says that he wishes he had one without a plastic stem. Well, you know, yeah, okay, there may be some that you can find with a horn stem. So I'll show you. This is made from plastic. I don't know what kind of plastic that you've got, but... Oh, and this is my peasant pipe. I showed this off on the show last year. So this is made out of every material a pipe can be made out of. Down here, this is ceramic. Ceramic bowl. This is a horn part with a cork. This is another horn part. And then this is plastic. Making a pipe out of plastic, making the pipe shank out of a specific kind of plastic is fairly standard. I forget what it's called. It starts with a V or something like Velarium or something. I don't know. I'd have to look into it. But it's traditional. You can sand it down and polish it up, so I wouldn't hate on plastic too much. But if it's like cheapo plastic, then yeah. And if you just got the corn cob pipe from like a gas station, it's probably made with cheap plastic. My recommendation would either to be find an antique shop in your local area, and I know there are a ton in San Francisco, or go onto eBay and look for some estate pipes. And you can find some really nice estate pipes on eBay for fairly cheap. You went to Grant's? Am I familiar with Grant's? Oh, the place we filmed that one time. Wait, you're not talking about the pub, are you? Did we film the show in a tobacco shop? Oh, that's right! Grant's Cigar Shop! Oh, that's awesome. So you went there to buy your pipe. Oh, that's right. Yeah, that was a great place. That was a classy place. We sat there in those leather chairs just smoking on those cigars. It was pretty sick. You got it there and it was still pretty cheap? Oh, man. Try and find something that was made like no later than the 70s. And then you might be able to find a pipe made with really good materials. That was a great little shop. Oh, it was $7. Oh, come on. What do you expect for a $7 pipe? You just wanted to see if you could get into it? Okay. Well, I hope you can get into it. We'll see. We'll see. It is hard to keep lit. One trick is to use a poker somehow, like an unwound clothespin or paperclip, and just poke a hole in the middle of your tobacco. And that makes a little bit of a chimney here. I'll make it a little wider. And that helps the fire sort of just, you know, breathe a little bit. And then be sure to tamp down the ash as you go. So mine's not too bad right now, but... And you never press into it. You just sort of crush the ashes on top. Just a little bit. Crush them on top. Gorn says, I like to sit out and watch the birds fly in and out of the yard while I smoke my pipe. You old fogey, you. Do you got a rocking chair, too? Do you just sort of go back and forth? You need a banjo. You already have the accordion, right? You need a banjo so that you can just... Honestly, I would play a banjo. I'm not even hating. I really like the banjo. I wish I could play it. All I have is the penny whistle. I want to play the banjo and the accordion and the harmonica. That would be great. Maybe even the harpsichord. But that's a bit of a far-fetched dream. Anyway, sorry, I have been talking about things I'm interested in. What are you guys interested in? What would you like to talk about? I'm here to answer your questions as well. Greg Hartung says Facebook. All right, yeah, I'm more than happy to answer questions on Facebook. Let's refresh Facebook here and see what's going on. Oh. Oh, Jeremy Mitchell says, did you join the Diablier Challenge? Is it too late? Jeremy, is it too late? Because I want to. I forgot to take a picture of my beard and post it on the Diablo thing. So I hope it's not too late. I'll try it. If it's not too late, I'll do it. Tyler says, hey, Oxhorn, what do you plan to do this Christmas? I plan to have a fantastic Christmas. So this will be Nova and Mine's, or Mine and Nova's. How do you do that? It's our first Christmas together as a couple. And we'll be married by then, actually. Yeah, we're getting married on the 3rd, so it'll be our first Christmas as a married couple. Wow, my phone is really acting up. There we go. So yeah, I'm really, really looking forward to it. We're going to have presents. I've already got a tree. We're actually going to decorate. Just going to hang out with family and have a good time. That's what Christmas is all about. But don't worry, I will not forget my viewers. I will broadcast on the appropriate days, Thursdays, when necessary, because I enjoy it. Every bit of it. Even my music messes up on me. Hey, Pandora. Don't be a jerk. Come on, Pandora.
Dig, man. There goes Mac the Knife.
There you go. Mac the Knife is good. The Dan Man says, is that a panda back there? I see a panda on the shelf. What? No. That's not a panda. That's a Tauren. Albeit a chibi Tauren. And that's Tyrael from Diablo 3. Tyrael. You're confusing Diablo 3 Tyrael with a panda? Oh, that's sad. All right, we're having music problems, so you know what? I'm gonna figure this out. Let's try. Slice 20 says, tra-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. I don't understand. Why would you say that? It's not even nice. Here we go. Yeah, much better. Gorn says, oh, are you going to be broadcasting from the wedding? I want to go, just got to see if I can get the time off work. Well, we would, of course, love to have you. I hope you got the invitation we sent you. If you can't get off work, I totally understand. It was kind of a last-minute thing that we put together. We're not going to be broadcasting it, though, because if there are any moments in Oxhorn's life that he can keep private and not share with the fans, it's going to be his wedding. So that will probably be a pretty private event. I hope you can go, though. If you can, that would be awesome. If not, I totally understand. But you gotta let me know when you and the lovely lady decide to tie the knot. And haven't I been pestering you about that for like 4 years now? Yeah. Oh! What is my wedding? It's a Saturday, isn't it? Yeah, I don't know if we'll be doing, if we'll have the chapel on Thursdays. I don't know, we'll see. Moonshinery says, as long as I see a few pictures, I'll be thrilled. Maybe I'll share some pictures. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe one. Maybe we'll pick one picture out and share it on Facebook. That's it. We'll see. Why? You guys are up in my personal business. You're wanting to see my pictures? And video of my wedding? Shoot. I don't know, guys. I'm going to have to talk it over with the lovely Nova. And we'll decide. Cheers to that. Decision making it later. Are you gonna get Scrim tonight? Says Sweet and Small. Wow! This game is on everybody's mind. No, I'm not gonna get Scrim tonight. I want to. But I'll probably have to wait until tomorrow. We shall see. All right, let me refresh Facebook so I don't miss anything. Pinkus Floyd, with two D's, says, where did you get that awesome torch lighter? I actually got it at my local gas station. No, it wasn't a gas station. It was a local cigar shop, yeah. It was kind of like a hole-in-the-wall place. It wasn't really fancy or anything, and it was just the closest thing near to me. But I saw this, and I was like, all right, let's try it out. And look! It's nice. I haven't refilled it once since I got it. I've had it for over a month and I haven't had to refill it. I mean, I don't smoke that much, maybe once or twice a week, but look at that. It's a nice little lighter. And the other ones, like this one, I bought this one specifically because it was supposed to be a pipe lighter. Because, you know, you go like that, and look. $60. 60 bleeding dollars. $12. I am not even kidding. $12. So, just pays to be a wise consumer, I guess. Old Ironbark says, I recently came across Gort's show with you on Wii Game. Will you ask him when he'll guest star on your show? I think that would be fun. Yeah, well, I mean, he's here now. We have to ask him. Gort, when are you going to come co-host Scotch and Smoke Rings with me up here, huh? You know, it's been like 3 or 4 years and you haven't even come to Seattle on vacation. When are you going to come to Seattle on vacation? If you do, you're going to have to co-host the show with me, all right? Now that you're a pipe guy, this will be great. You can smoke some pipes. Show them how it's done. Gort says, I'd love to. When should I visit? You should visit, like, probably after the wedding. Like, January. January, middle of January, or February sometime. Whenever. I'm always happy to entertain. That's what gentlemen do. Courtney and I will come up for a long weekend. He says, perfect. Holding you to it. Shaking your hand right now. There you go. Set in stone, man. Bean Blossom says, how come whenever I am on, Brian is not there? Well, Brian actually is doing fairly gentlemanly pursuits right now. He is on a date. Yes, I know. I'm not even making it up. And it's a very good reason. Of all the reasons out there to skip co-hosting this show with his own brother, a date is a good one. He is on a date, having a very good time. Guess where he's taking her? I'm so proud of him. This is my brother. He is taking her to the symphony. This guy, he's like so suited for co-hosting Scotch and Smoke Rings with me because he is a classy gentleman. He's taking this girl to the symphony, right? Their first date. Classier than me, Gort. I should let you know, my first date with Nova, symphony. The Cincinnati Symphony. I took her there. That was our very first date. I'm saying, you cannot hate. You cannot hate. That's how it's done. We Dennis brothers, we know. We know how to treat the ladies. It's just part of our genes. That's our DNA. Gort says, I take Courtney to the opera. What's classier? That is a very good question. I have taken Nova to the opera once. We went and saw The Magic Flute by Mozart, actually, which was amazing. We had box seats for that. And I've only taken her once, and I took her to the symphony once. What's classier, symphony or opera? It's hard. It's hard to say. I might have to lean towards opera. Because the opera has music, whereas the symphony just has music and no acting. I don't know. They're both great choices. Gab17 says, I'm being ignored. I is a very sad panda. Oh, well, lol. Gabs, what are you talking about? I've been answering all of your questions. And they're always about how much you hate smoke. If you talked about interesting things, maybe I would answer more often. Gosh. Smoke. Tobacco is gross. And yet here I am, watching Scotch and Smokers. Does it make sense? Doesn't? Oh, they're not always about smoke? Did you ask another question? Okay. I'm getting people to tell me to refresh Facebook. Okay, let me refresh Facebook. Oh, I'm sorry, Gavs. I'm sorry that I haven't answered all of your questions. Don't take it personally. I've got nothing against you, you smoke hater. There's a lot of people here. Look at all the people in this chat. It's a lot of people. I'll do my best, all right? I'm one man. Only got 2 eyes, and there are like 70 of you. All right. Sorry, refreshing Facebook. Joel Bryson says, could we as fans send you anything for Christmas? Absolutely. You are free to send me as much as you want. In fact, if you really want to send me a Christmas present, I have my wedding registry up on oxhorn.com. You're more than welcome to find something on there and send it to me. I've got stuff in that registry that's $10. I've got stuff that's like $300. Whatever. Whatever's within your budget. I know all of you are within that $300 region, right? Yeah, I know it. I know it. Greg Hartung says, given your love of all things Scandinavian, would you love to have the vehicle a playable race in WoW? Absolutely. I very much would. I love the vehicle. They're so cool. The Vrykul. They're some of my favorite non-playable races. Those and the Tusks, the Tuskar. Those guys are cool. Jeremy Mixer says, can you give out a salute to all the veterans? I am in the Air Force. I can, but here's the thing. I was never in the military. So I can't, in all good consciousness, give the four-finger salute. Because that is only the domain of those who have actually served in the armed forces. However, I was a Boy Scout. I'm an Eagle Scout. That's right, you are listening to an Eagle Scout talk about video games and tobacco. And we salute with three fingers. Because we're not quite up to the level of the four-fingered salute. So, I will give you a three-fingered Boy Scout salute, sir, for serving our country. Pleasure to have you here. Moonlight Serenade says, hey Ox, have you ever drank cognac? Spelled with two K's. How do you spell cognac with two K's? In a little, can we get some Girl from Ipanema, Frank Sinatra? Oh man, that's a great song. As for cognac, I have had cognac before. A very fine beverage, I will admit. Made from grapes, not necessarily distilled from the fine grain, but a classy beverage nonetheless. And I can and will do requests when asked. It just so happens that I have Frank Sinatra on my phone, right? And if I can find it, let's see. Search Ipanema. Oh, man. Come on, Frank. Frank Sinatra. What? I had the entire album. Why isn't it on my phone? Okay. Going all the way down. Lots of Celtic music here. No Frank Sinatra? Oh, wait. What? Oh, man. Fantasia? I've got Fantasia on here? That's cool. No, how can I not have Sinatra? Oh, I'm bombed. Well, I what I will do instead, and you may be lucky and hear the Girl from Ipanema, I will instead turn on Frank Sinatra Radio on Pandora. How's that? Alright. Tom Marr says, Ox, I know you have pandas and WoW, but in your honest opinion, what do you think will be the aftermath of MOOP from what you have seen now? Look, I don't want to be hating on World of Warcraft because you know how much I love World of Warcraft and Blizzard. They make fantastic games. When I heard about Mists of Pandaria, I was really genuinely bummed. The nuggety center of Oxhorn's World of Warcraft soul was crushed when I heard about Mists of Pandaria. I just feel like they're turning what was once what is still a very, very wonderful game into something like Hello Kitty Island Adventure, you know? I don't play a giant mythical minotaur that tears things limb from limb so that my buddy in battle is a bumbly little fuzzy panda. I don't! That's not why I play World of Warcraft. But maybe I'm taking it a little too seriously. I don't know. Do I think Mists of Pandaria are going to be the end of World of Warcraft? No, of course not. World of Warcraft is an amazing game. They've got awesome dedicated fans. I will mention that they are down to 10 million players. At their height, they had, what, 14 million? That's a lot of millions that they lost. I don't know what that means. Maybe it just means people are tired of MMOs. Oh, 12 million? Greg Hartung says that the height of their popularity was 12 million. All right, I'm not sure what it was. But even so, that's 2 million. That's a lot of millions. So, I wish them all the best. I hope Mists of Pandaria is a wonderful decision for them. I just am personally a little disappointed. Thank you, Frank. Keep on singing, buddy. Oh, okay. We have an interesting request here. So Mike Chessel says on Twitter, "Dear Oxhorn, you should read Flanders Fields into Songify. If you don't know what it is, it's a popular World War I poem. And here's the link to it." Thank you, sir. You are being quite accommodating for this version, this episode. Okay, this is a... All right, so apparently Flanders Fields is a World War I poem written by a soldier on the battlefield. And I believe we're going to be making a historic thing here. We're going to be taking a poem that a man wrote when he was in the midst of battle, fighting for his life, and we're going to put it into song within 60 seconds. You guys ready? Oh, you sing it as a song? Song says Thoradin. I've never sung this as a song. All right, we're going to try it. Here we go. In Flanders fields the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields. I know how you brought that up, because we talked about poppies earlier, right? Here we go.
Fields, the poppies blow, between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from feeling hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though still bravely singing fly. Scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders. Take up our quarrel with the...
Okay, so that was that. Interesting. Success, I say. That was a success, a Songify success here at Oxhorn.com, or I should say ScotchandSmokeRings.com, because now we're on ScotchandSmokeRings.com. So thank you for that suggestion. We made Songify even better today. Oh, hold on. Come on. All right. I think I know what's wrong with my music, and it's because I don't have my Wi-Fi card thing turned on. I was streaming that all over 3G. That's not right. All right, let's turn on Wi-Fi, choose Motorola. That's right, I didn't give a clever name to my Wi-Fi connection. I probably should have. Just called Motorola. All right, come on, Pandora, play. Ooh. Ah. Try restarting Pandora or rebooting your iPhone. All right, iPhone, I will reboot you because you asked me to. But you're a jerk. Oh well, we still have Scotch. We still have smoke rings. And we only have 10 minutes left in the program. Wow, Crindor says, awesome seeing you at BlizzCon. First time watching your stream since then. Our voiceover did well. Indeed, Walkrendor. That was a lot of fun doing that voiceover. Yours was amazing. You were hilarious. I had an absolute blast. It was great to meet you finally after all these long times. What? I'm debating going back to playing WoW. Can you help me decide? Should I stay or should I go? Says Hattel. You know, that's up to you. Does playing a massive multiplayer online RPG appeal to you right now in your life? Is that what you want to do? Do you want to farm for gold and get achievements and collect pets and mounts and make sure that your character is wearing only the latest of equipment and gear? If so, then that game is for you. You should log on immediately and play it with every fiber of your being. If, however, on the other hand, you are more inclined to, I don't know, go up to some German and blow his brains out, then maybe an FPS is more in your direction. Because as we all know, the best FPSs are all about killing Germans for some reason. I don't know. Alright, let's try music. Come on, music. Oh, no. Okay, here we go. Patrick, a PvP queen on Twitter, says, Oxhorn, question. Can you do a salute for me, too? Oh, can you do a salute to me and a friend, Cloud Can Talk? She is a soldier who is going to be home in a couple more weeks. Thanks. Absolutely. Let's do a three-fingered Boy Scout salute to Patrick's friend Cloud Can Talk. And just so that I don't have to manually salute every single person who has served in the military that watches this fine program, here's a salute to everyone who has served in the military or is a family member of someone who has served in the military who watches this fine program. There you go. No, this is a good one. You are welcome, Primal. Absolutely. Out together, dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to climb a mountain and to reach the highest peak. But it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I love to go out fishing in a river or a stream or a creek. I said stream, didn't I? It's dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, Cloud Can Talk on Twitter made that suggestion. Well, I just saw it now, so pleasure to see you, Cloud Can Talk, and thank you for your submission this week. Okay, thanks, Gorn. I know creek rhymes with cheek. Stream kind of rhymes with cheek. No, not really, but it's close. Raul Zala says, Ox, what's your favorite movie? Children of Men. I think Children of Men is my favorite movie. It was great. It was a great movie. I mean, usually when you watch a movie like that, here's the plot. I'm going to break it down for you. I'm sorry about this ahead of time, but I'm about to spoil every single science fiction or action-packed futuristic movie that has ever been made. With the exception of a few. I'm about to spoil them all to you, for you right now. Here's the plot. A big, giant government is controlling the little people and making their lives a living hell. And randomly kidnapping people and killing them for no reason. Just because they're evil and big. Or, in place of government, corporations. Big corporations killing people because they're evil and big. But there is light at the end of the tunnel. Because one small group of rebels, of whom the main hero is a part, has broken away from this giant collective and is fighting against the man. And you get to watch them as they go through the movie, fighting the military, of course, because as we all know, if you're in the military while wielding a gun, you're a bad person, if Hollywood is correct. So fighting the military and fighting nameless goons with ninja kicks and tomahawks and laser rifles or whatever, until you come face to face with the leader of the horrible organization and you have a duel of some sort. Or maybe a long-winded soliloquy about how, you know, the little man needs to be helped or something, and it ends up with someone dying and civilization crumbling, a la Aeon Flux or something. So there you go, I just spoiled half of all of Hollywood for you. I'm so sorry. That's just the way it goes sometimes. I gotta say, I don't necessarily always agree with the way Hollywood depicts people. Certain people. Just saying. That is my personal opinion. Wow, why are you all hating on Avatar? I didn't even mention Avatar. Kat says it was Pocahontas in space. I may not have mentioned Avatar, but did I mention Avatar? I may have, while not mentioning it. Anyway, spoiled all of Hollywood for you, what can I say? The Dan Man says, Dark Helmet, I am your father's brother's nephew's cousin's former roommate. That was great. Mel Brooks, there's just something about Mel Brooks, right? Can't go wrong. Patrick says, smoke ship time. Indeed, it is smoke ship time. What would you guys like to see? I am here to blow into existence a smoke ship of your creation, as I do every week here at scotchandsmokerings.com. Give me some ideas. What would you like to see? And I will do my best to create such a creation with the smoke that issues forth from my gums. Refreshing Facebook. Don't worry. Gabby says, hey Ox, now I'm on Facebook. How do you like them apples? Oh my god. You're just following me everywhere now. Lorenica says, Ox and Nova getting married on a giant bacon bowler boat in a Scotch sea with Frank Sinatra playing the Great Kodo on a smoke ring blowing piano while Bean punts gnomes into double rainbows. My... That's a great... Okay, here's a tip, guys. If you really want me to do your smoke ship, tweet it to me. Because everything in this chat flies off the screen really fast and I lose it. So try and tweet it to me and I'll do my best. Oxhorn saluting with the Eagle Scout salute the veterans while fireworks taking form of bacon and the American flag. That's pretty epic. Very patriotic. Gonzalo the Goblin says, Ox of Virkul and Tuskar battling super cute pandas aboard a molasses ship sailing on a sea of Irish whiskey. That's nice. Todd's Turtle Left says, would it be cheaper to buy a pipe and tobacco online or try and find a cigar shop? It would be cheaper to buy it online, but you may not have as wide of a selection as opposed to going to a cigar shop. I don't know. I like to go to cigar and pipe shops just because their selection is right there, and you can kind of feel things and see how they feel. So. Wow, my Facebook is blowing up. Frank Sinatra says, Pandarians wearing elf masks being killed by Ox and Nova on a bacon boat. That's nice as well. Bacon-shaped tank with Ox saluting to the soldiers while pandas fly fighter planes and Bean driving a giant robot. I don't know, I'm out of ideas. Says Patrica. Yeah, I know. What? Okay, Loranicus, I like yours a lot. That's... I don't know how I'm going to remember that, though. Okay, I'm copying it and opening up a notepad document. And I'm pasting it. Oh, and I didn't get it. I got something else. Man, it's hard for me to... I can't... Sorry, Loranicus. I like it, but it's hard. It flies off the screen. Oxenova getting married on a giant bacon bowler boat. Giant bacon bowler boat. In a Scotch sea with Frank Sinatra playing the great Kodo on a smoke ring blowing piano while Bean punts gnomes into the double rainbows. Okay, I think I can do this. You'll have to let me know if I miss anything. In space is Sly 20. I know you just like space. So just putting it in space makes it better. I like space. I mean, orcs were better in space. So there you go. All right. Okay, here we go. Oxenova getting married on a giant bacon bowler boat in a Scotch sea with Frank Sinatra playing the great Kodo on a smoke ring bowling, blowing piano while Bean punts gnomes into double rainbows. Getting married on a giant bacon bowler boat. Giant bacon bowler boat on a Scotch sea. All right, I can do this. All right, guys, are you ready? Here we go. Time for some smoke rings. I may need to relight. All right, here we go. Pay attention. I hope you didn't blink, because if you did, you missed it. But Ox and Nova were on a giant bowler ship on a Scotch sea. It was a bacon bowler ship on a Scotch sea. And Frank Sinatra was there on a piano that was blowing smoke rings while Beanstalk, a.k.a. my brother, was punting gnomes off into the distance. That's right. That's right, I didn't forget. And oh no, into double rainbows, right? And it was all there too. I'm not just remembering the double rainbows right now. No, it was in that smoke ship that I just blew into existence. So, in space, thank you, in space. It was all there, the stars and the constellations there, in that smoke ship that was briefly on the screen for just a moment. You should have taken a screenshot, because now it's gone. It's gone forever, but there you go. I know you guys saw it. It was pretty mind-blowing. Double rainbows. All the way across the space. That's just what happens. I know. I get it. You guys have eyes and you saw it. Well, thank you, ladies and gents, for coming to this week's episode of Scotch and Smoke Rings. It was a fantastic episode because you guys were here and it was a lot of fun. Thank you so much for coming. Be sure to like scotchandsmokerings.com and Google Plus it so that we can get it up in the rankings and go through all of the episodes. If you want to watch previous episodes, you can search for them in the little search bar just below, and you can browse them on the episodes page. Leave a comment. Feel free to leave a comment. I've integrated it with Facebook, so you can use your Facebook account to leave a comment if you want. And be sure to read the About page and like it while you're there, because it's all about interesting things that are gentlemanly and classy. Well, thanks for coming, ladies and gents. See you next week. Same Ox time, same Ox channel, Scotch and Smoke Rings. And as always, we say here at scotchandsmokerings.com, be sure, my friends, to stay classy.